managing reference data poorly can have a profound impact on your operations as well as business intelligence and analytical outcomes. So here's what you need to do. Here are three best practices for managing reference data. For the other two, please click on the link in the description below and it will take you to the accompanying article where you can read about all five. First, subscribe to external reference data. As a default, it's recommended to first consult reference data provided by third-party standard authorities such as the ISO, SWIFT, ACORD, ICD, and so on. Defaulting to these saves you a lot of time internally, excluding the resources required to discover, understand, and adopt, and sometimes purchase this data, and you can be confident that you're adopting the standards from a reliable source. By the way, check out this video to learn of the three crucial tips on using ISO 3166 for your country's reference data. Let's say you've adopted the external reference data. This usually does not ensure a subscription to any updates. So you need to ensure that any changes done by the third-party authority are quickly determined and integrated into your master tables. For example, the codes for countries and their subdivisions can change on an average of 3 times a year. Yeah, I was surprised about that too. Sometimes a paid subscription is available, which would allow you to get instant notifications or integration with your technical environment via an API. Please keep in mind that the ramifications for updating this data don't just stop at the table level, but carry on within documentation and training, metadata and definitions, as well as anything that's hard-coded, such as forms and reports and dashboards. Before we carry on, I want to thank the sponsor of this video, Dataedo. Dataedo allows you to catalog, document, and understand your data with their data dictionary, business glossary, and ER diagrams. Check them out and get a 30-day trial of using Dataedo for free. Additionally, use the following coupon code for a 10% discount on your purchase. Both links are available in the video's description, so start boosting your data and software initiatives today. Okay, the first best practice was to subscribe to external reference data. The second is to manage reference data at the enterprise level. Reference data management needs to support multiple domains in order to avoid reference data silos. This outcome is dependent on the data governance operating model you adopt. As this becomes widely used across different enterprise systems, distribution of updates and new entries needs to be addressed. A data bus or a data hub is a common solution as it provides a central location from which any application can import its reference data from. This import can happen automatically by pulling the data through an API, a subscription type, or an automatic read-write function, or manually by a batch or static file. If the import occurs manually due to technical limitations, communication of any updates occurring at the data bus level should be passed on to the data stewards within the impacted business domains and to the data custodians of the impacted applications. Third best practice is version your reference data. As reference data has a wide prevalence across your systems, you not only need to ensure it is up to date across the enterprise, but that you can keep track of its changes. This is particularly useful in data integration projects. And addressing master data management needs and business intelligence deliverables. One needs to know the effective date of the change and what was it changed from in order to address all of these. Have you considered managing your reference data? What best practices did you adopt or create? Let me know in the comments below. Remember, for the other two best practices, check out lightsondata.com. Here you can also find more informative content such as templates and guides, best practices, articles, and other useful resources to help you with your data governance and data management questions and challenges. So please like the video if you've enjoyed it. And don't forget to subscribe to never miss out on great content. Thank you.